Hello friends, welcome back again. In the last video, I demonstrated how you can pull up the ledger balances from Tally into Excel by sending XML commands using Power Query. Now this time I am going to send XML commands which will fetch transactions or vouchers of any ledger. So let's see. Before you start import, ensure that you keep open the company from which you wish to pull out the data. Okay, and the second, this setting of Tally. Okay, I will click here. Tally is acting as client and server. Okay, so this setting should be enabled. Now the next step would be to grab a ready-made Power Query which will fetch this data. So just go to Google Chrome and in Google search type GitHub and Dhananjay Gokhale. Okay, so I have uploaded a ready-made open source project of Power Query. So just open up this project, Excel Kida Power Query Library, and in this go to Tally ledger vouchers.pq. okay, so friends, this is the Power Query which can fetch the transactions of any ledger. Okay, so I will click raw and we will just first select this and copy this Power Query. Okay, now let us open Excel and go to data tab, get data, and we will launch Power Query editor. Okay, so this is the Power Query editor which you can see on the screen. Now I will click new source, other sources, and we will create a blank Power Query, and let us name this Power Query, let's say ledger. Okay, and I will click advanced editor and paste this ready-made Power Query. Okay, now if you inspect this Power Query, you need to give from and to date for this. Okay, and the ledger name you wish to import. So now this is the default I have given. Please change it according to you. Okay, just specify the name of the ledger you wish to import and with correctly all the spaces. Okay, now I will click done because I already set it. Okay, let's see. I will click refresh again. So friends, can you see this ledger table imported? So these are the transactions or vouchers of complete 1 year. Okay, now let us click close and load. So this is the ledger of cash, so I will rename it. Okay, now as you can see in this Power Query, minus means debit and plus means credit. Okay, because in Tally, in amount column you get debit and credit. Okay, now let's say I want to split this transaction, so I want a separate column for debit and credit. Okay, so let us modify this Power Query. So I will go to data, queries and connection, and I will right click and edit this Power Query. Okay, now I will insert one more column. Okay, so let's say I don't want this narration column, so I will remove this, and instead now I will add one column. Okay, so I will click custom column, and this, let's say this column is debit. Okay, now if this amount is less than zero, then this amount into minus one. Okay, otherwise zero, otherwise zero. Let's see. Okay, so we have multiplied the minus sign with minus one, so all the debits you can see in positive signs. Now let us do the same activity for credit also. credit if this amount column is greater than 0, then the same amount should be repeated, otherwise 0 should be here. Let's click OK. Okay, so this is credit column. Now I can safely remove this amount column also. Okay, I'll click on the remove this. Okay, now why are you seeing three dots? So you may see these three dots. Now what does it mean? So if any now there are few entries in my case that where multiple debit and credit is there. So for a, let's say for a credit single debit is found, or for a debit single credit is found, then that ledger name would be there. But if multiple debit and credit is found, then you would see three dots for it. Okay, now let us close and load it. Okay, so you can see the result. Now this data is very easy for analysis, so let's format it nicely first. So I'll use comma formatting, and now you can apply any types of filters in Excel. Okay, so let's say I want to filter cash payments about 20,000 or 30,000, so I can easily filter it like this. So you can simply do this. Now let's say I want to import another ledger. So do you have to repeat the same steps? No, you can simply copy paste this Power Query. How you can do this? Just have a look. I will go to again data tab and launch the Power Query editor, and let's say I want to import conveyance accounts. Okay, spelling is wrong of conveyance. Okay, don't worry. So I will make a copy of this. Okay, so I will duplicate this Power Query, and let's say this is conveyance account. Okay, and I will click on the advanced editor and just change the name. Okay, change the name of the ledger. Conveyance account. Okay, let's click done. Okay, so you can see the ledger entries for this. Let us close and load this. So this is ledger of conveyance. Okay, so like this you can import multiple ledgers, and these transactions or vouchers are dynamic. So if any changes are made in Tally, you just need to right click here and click refresh. So Power Query will again fetch it fresh copy of it. Okay, so I hope you understood this technique, and if you find it difficult, then there is a proverb in Marathi for you. Kelyane hot ahere, adi kelech paije. It means simply watching video is not sufficient. You will have to at least try it or attempt it once, then only you will learn. So friends, if you want to get updated about future videos, please subscribe to my channel.